This is where I leave you, my lord. I'm not permitted to show myself on the occupied floors of the Red Keep.
Why? Do you also have problems with the law?
No, but Lord Varys doesn't want the court to know too much about his little birds. He's quite insistent on that. Go up one more floor. On your right, you'll see a passage leading to the entrance to the dungeons. Lord Varys will find you there.
In that case, go, before the other guards arrive. You've been a great help.
The honor was all mine, my lord. Good speed.
Alistair, finally. I had begun to worry that your adventure had come to a most unfortunate end.
It was a close call. The tunnels are swarming with guards. Your little bird came in quite handy.
Yes. This dear treasure is very resourceful, discreet, and loyal too.
What next? Which path must I take to reach the Queen?
Most importantly, have you considered what you will say to her when she asks how you escaped?
I will use it to demonstrate my talents. If she is as ambitious as you have described, she will value my services that much more.
Excellent. It would be very unfortunate for both of us if my name were to reach the Queen's ears. She probably hates me as much as she does her imp of a brother. The throne room is at the top of the stairs behind me. At this hour, you should find the Queen in the upper gallery.
You always find a way to win on all fronts, don't you?
As for me, I will make these bodies disappear. It wouldn't do to add this massacre to your charge. Good luck, my lord. And remember, the Queen does not like to be taken for a fool.
Halt! Who are you? State your business!
I am Alistair Sarwick, loyal servant to the Crown. I wish to have an audience with Queen Cersei.
The Queen only receives petitioners when holding court. Why don't you explain how you got into the throne room instead? Guards, seize him!
Just a moment, Sir Celtigar. Bring me that man.
My thanks for granting me an audience, Your Grace. I am Alistair Sarwick of Riverspring, bannerman to House Lannister.
Yes, that name conjures something. You're the man who was arrested for murdering the Goldcloaks. What I don't know, on the other hand, is how you managed to barge straight into the heart of the Red Keep. Explain to me, then, how you were able to evade the palace guard.
Your Grace, with all due respect, I cannot answer that.
Really? You're playing a very dangerous game, Sir Alistair. I appreciate persistence, but a sensible man should always know when to submit. I will ask you one more time. How were you able to accomplish that feat?
Means matter little to one such as myself. What truly count are the ends. I could have left this keep without looking back, but I would rather offer my talents to the Crown.
You may rise, sir. You have my full attention.
Many thanks, Your Grace.
Despite your goodwill, know that you are taking terrible risks. If I must take you into my service, I would first be certain of your absolute loyalty. How did a prisoner such as yourself come all the way up from the dungeons?
That answer is the only thing I cannot give you, Your Grace. At least for the moment.
This is not what I expected of you, sir. You disappoint me.
Please forgive me, Your Grace.
Enough! Guards, seize him.
Just a moment, Your Grace, I beg of you.
You have one more chance to satisfy me, Sir Alistair. There will be no more second chances. I'm listening.
Your Grace, this escape proves but one of my talents. If you allow me to offer my services to you alone, I promise to show you that I am capable of even greater feats.
Why do you wish to assist me? What is it you want?
I learned that my sister, Elyana, was promised to Valar. An unfortunate choice, I'm afraid.
How so?
Because he is bastard-born, Your Grace. Not only would it be a poor alliance, but our father's blood runs in his veins. I cannot accept such an improper marriage.
Let me remind you that Sir Valar was knighted by my own father, Lord Tywin Lannister. That alone should convince you of his merit as future Lord of Riverspring. And if I'm not mistaken, your brother Garwin is accused of killing your father, is he not? When your sister came to see me, I saw no other choice. Sir Valar grew up at Riverspring in the heart of the castle itself. He was the one capable of ensuring the protection of these lands, as well as that of your sisters.
With your permission, my lady, I have returned, and as the firstborn son of my house, it is up to me to decide what happens to my family. No doubt my long absence has left me but a distant memory to many here, but I am still my father's lawful heir.
Why do you not submit your grievance to the king when he is holding court? I'm certain that your request will be granted.
Riverspring is under the rule of House Lannister. In any decision regarding its future, the king will defer to you or to your father. I decided to come straight to you in order to avoid wasting time.
Very astute, my lord. But you will understand that, however generous she may be, a queen may not act strictly out of charity. There are important tasks which must be carried out with the utmost discretion and efficiency. Would you be ready to undertake such a task for your queen?
My loyalty to my queen has never wavered. Tell me what you wish of me, and I will not disappoint.
Very well, Sir Alistair. Your request has been heard. Serve me well, and I will make certain that Riverspring is returned to you. Disappoint me, and we will allow the king's justice to follow its course in your regard.
That will not happen.
I am delighted to hear that. We have it from reliable sources that enemies of the Crown are running unchecked in King's Landing, and I want their heads. And since it appears that you and Sir Valar have the same objective, it is my wish that you carry out this mission together. And why not use this opportunity to find out who is more dedicated, you or your half-brother?
Your Grace, I would like to discuss one last matter with you. It concerns my brother, Garwin. I was at Riverspring for my father's burial, and there is, for the moment, no proof that my brother killed our father. I know not who informed the Crown of my brother's guilt, but it would seem that he was judged too quickly. I dare ask one more favor of you. Please withdraw this accusation until there is formal proof of his guilt.
I see. It is an enormous boon that you ask of me. Very well. To prove my faith in your abilities, I will lift the reward on your brother's head. The watch will leave him in peace, for the moment.
I praise your Grace's generosity.
For now, go and await me in the antechamber. There are matters I must discuss in private with Sir Valar. We will speak again shortly.
Frighten me. been reading too many fables, my friend. No.
Come on now. You're underestimating Lannister. She's the one.
Now, my dear, they are just...
Alistair, what are you doing here? You were supposed to rot in the dungeons.
That is indeed what I feared, but the light of R'hllor guided my steps out.
Sir Velaryon, the Queen awaits your presence.
We shall meet again, Alistair.
Sooner than you think.